Hello everyone and welcome back to Dragalia Lost. As promised, today we have another gacha featuring Tiki from the Fire Emblem series, as you might expect. So, as I promised last time, we will go all in on this. So, no fear, no preoccupation that we will miss this character. I have about more than 100 pulls, so this should be not really hard to do. Hopefully, if we get there really early, we will manage to get Chrome as well, and we will complete the trio of the new characters from Fire Emblem. So, let's get into the gacha. I have no tickets for the 10 pool, but I still have to get the one from the event. So, if we fail totally, at least I have a saving grace for later. But I didn't manage to farm all the stuff because this weekend, as you saw, was full of other videos that I have to do. Now, let's start with 10 pulls. I have some single pull tickets, of course, but they aren't really a lot, so won't start with those. Now, if we manage to get Tiki like in 2 or 3 pulls, we will go into Chrome as promised, but getting Chrome will be harder than getting Tiki. Why, you might ask? Because they upped the rate to get Tiki. She's at 0.8 instead of 0.5. Nice, new dragon. Just what I wanted. And that is really good for single hero banners, because it means that the single rate up is better than the double rate up. Which is something that I wanted to see since before it was kinda bad. Ah, you don't have this dragon, Ariel. Really good. At least getting a new dragon means that I get more Wyrmite, so it's not really something that I can get mad at. Okay, it seems like we might have something good here. Let's hope that it's Tiki, guys. If we get her early, as I said earlier, we can get Chrome. 2 SSRs. Dragon. Come on, give us a dagger. Yes! Ah, yes! Finally, some good luck, we can go to Grom. Ok, Prometheus have. Also the only dragon that I gave the augments for dragons. I wonder what happened with those. We had the augments for dragons and weapons and now they are gone, basically. Maybe they changed their idea. Nice! Really, really nice. Of course, after this segment, I will do a Shulky pull only for Tiki. If you wanted to see the Chrome and Peony one, go check out the their gacha. At the end, I do the Shulky pull. Okay, so this is Tiki. As I said last time, she's the best adventurer out of the three of them because she has a new mechanic. Basically, she's built all around her dragon, but the dragon works like a dragon overdrive, kinda like Holdred. So you can get in the dragon form, get out it and get it in it again just by using her abilities. The first ability is basically a area attack, and the second ability just gives her some dragon gojo. I will go into depth about this later, but she's really good for DPS. So if you are looking for a new DPS for water, get her. Water doesn't really have a lot of amazing DPS to work with. But now she will be probably the best one, since daggers are already a really good weapon for DPS, or at least I think they are. Then stuff will be different from what I say. So, now we go for Chrome. We start again with 10 pulls, and hopefully we get our boy Chrome before not too long. Last time we managed to get 5 star heroes that weren't on rate up for whatever reason. So we already got a... I call them SSR, but they are 5 star. We already got a 5 star, but it's a dragon. So far we have 3 dragons and 1 adventurer, but it's the adventurer that we wanted. After this banner we will have a rerun of the Loyalty Requiem, the first event of the game with Seliera. And we will have a water banner. I wonder with who. I can't really say I know who they will put on the banner. And then after that one we will probably have a light banner. So there is something that I saw earlier before I log into the game. That basically... Oh, sword! Did we manage to get Chrome and we get out of this gacha with so many Wyrmites, guys? That will be the dream. Let's see. Yes! Yes, we finally did it. We finally got what we wanted before wasting all our, of our weirdness. I'm so happy about this, and finally, guys. Finally, the good luck was on our side. And of course, now, let me tell you something. Chrome is the worst of the three. Not that he's bad, but as I said in the Shouldiopole video, his second ability takes way too much to charge up, and you can miss it, and that would ruin your DPS. Compared to Mart, the other, the best fire sword, is kinda bad. But that doesn't mean you can't use him. He has a cool niche, where if you saw some videos around the net, he can do basically so high damage with his third ability, or second ability if you will, that he can basically trivialize some fights like Volker. So I can see that there is a use for him. Also, he has a pretty cool background art. Those in the background are his sister on the left, Lisa, and on the right his best friend Frederick, both that help him work with his unit, the Shepherds. Of course, I would have liked to see the player character in Awakening, Robin or Darain. Now I know that it's called Robin in English. But this is fine as well, it's kinda cool. If you want to see his shoulder pull, go check out the other gacha video that I did for the first two parts. So this went amazingly, we got everything that we wanted. We still have 7000 Wyrmites, which I will probably use for the Galadragalia at this point. And we have two new adventurer stories to explore. I will do Tigi after this video. And then tomorrow I will do Grom. And then the Fire Emblem Heroes event story will come maybe on Wednesday or maybe on Thursday. I already have all the parts recorded until the latest one. More stuff that I will do. I will do a Trials video, since now we have Trial for Grom. I will do Peony, Tiki and Grom in the same video. I will do it while I'm talking, because their trials are already in the main story, so a non-voice part will be in the event story video. And then we should have also a new defensive battle video. And as you can see here on the top right, we also have a Colosseum. How I will land a Colosseum? I will likely do one video for element, since there are 5 elements. Maybe at the hardest difficulty, not sure if I will do the hardest one, because they are meant to be really hard, but I will give you an overview of the fights. Also, last thing, as I said about some stuff I saw before coming into the video. Leaf has a light element into the Colosseum. What does this mean? That if we get Galalief at the end of the Montas, I expect he will be light. So expect a new light. Hopefully not Sword but Blade, but maybe we'll rival with Hyuden, Gala Hyuden. Even if I don't think it's possible, since he's one of the best units. Also, I wanted to check out if we have a new Wyrmprince. Hopefully we do, because I really enjoy getting Wyrmprince, since I have so much held water from pulling dupes. No, doesn't look like we have new ones. Okay. Now I will do a Should You Pull on Tiki. Thank you very much for all of those who joined me for the pulls. This time we went really well. Hopefully you guys go amazingly as well. And I will see you next time for the gacha. Maybe I will do a gacha with the Loyalty Regram one that is coming next week. We will see. So, let's start the Should You Pull. This is Tiki. As you can see, she is a dragon-based adventurer just from her background art. But she isn't like Mim and Latna, because her dragon transformation is a dragon overdrive. What does this mean? A dragon overdrive basically can turn into a dragon whenever you want. You don't really have to wait until the bar charges fully. And also, Tiki can charge her bar by her abilities. The first ability, Divine Wings, basically is an area damage, really quick ability also, so not really good to do high framing. And when you connect this ability, you get Dragon Overdrive Gauches. Dragon Valor also gives you Dragon Overdrive Gauches, but it doesn't do damage or anything, it's just a big boost that you can do immediately. When you transform, you get two abilities for the dragon, and not just one. The first one is just a breath, so frontal damage and inflicts frostbite. The second one is a dash and explosion, kind of like when Brunilda in High Brunilda does her dash and explosion on you, the one with the purple circle. And also deals bonus damage to Frostbitten foes, so she kinda works off Frostbitten. We don't have a Frostbitten Punisher Wimprint yet, but I imagine that she will use that really handily. So, about her co-ability, she gives standard attack damage, a really unique co-ability, we've never seen this one before, which I guess people can use it really good because it's based all around attack damage, and of course Dragon Ace as expected. Then we have Dragon Scion, which is the Dragon Gauche ability, so nothing really that I haven't said here. Okay, then we have Burner S, which of course we go for 100%, and she has Frostbitten Punisher implemented in her mana circles, so I guess if she gets a win print, she will be really good in damage. Now, my review of Tiki. I honestly didn't expect her to have two dragon abilities. This means that she's really, really good, because if every time she turns into a dragon, you can do two abilities, then turn back, then turn in and do other two abilities, her damage can be off the charts. Is she better than Peony? Probably, because Peony, as I saw, had a problem in charging up her abilities. They take kinda too long to make her rival to Galagleo. While Tiki could be amazing, because Dagger usually charge up abilities really fast. So what Wimprints do I expect to put on it? Probably Dragon Claw and Dragon Haste. I think the pin-up meme Wimprints has those. Let me check out. I usually am a fan of Dragon Adventurers, as you might know. Dragon Claw and Dragon... Yes, this one is really good for her, the Red Impulse, and also the one, the Bridal Dragon, because it has Dragon Prep. I wonder how Dragon Prep works with Dragon Overdrive. But of course the main, let's say the main ability of your Tiki is getting into a Dragon form, so that's what you want to do immediately. Personally, I feel like she's better than Peony, but not really of a lot. And she's probably the best DPS on Dragon. Let's wait for the experts' opinions on that, but I think she will be the best DPS on Dragon. So if you have Wyrmite, if you have tickets, pull for her. As you can see, as I said earlier, she has a 0.8. Look at that, she has a 0.8 pull rate, so you can get her really, really more easily. And like my ideal team on water is this one. She can safely take Mitsuba place. Mitsuba is really good, don't get me wrong. But she wrecks Mitsuba with damage, I'm sure of that. So, hope you enjoyed this Should You Pull for Tiki. And I will see you next time with the Colosseum and Trial videos, where I will comment without fear. And hopefully next week with the Gacha we manage to get an interesting adventurer. If so, I will likely use some tickets on him. And save the rest for the Gala at the end of the month, because you know, we always want to get our Gala character to complete our Gala stories, since we got all of them. Hopefully this event is treating you well, hopefully you got Tiki, Peony, Grom and whatever else you need, and hopefully you leave a like and a feedback on this video for me. Thank you very much, remember if you want to support the channel, to sub. I really need to reach a higher number so my video can go around the site without getting buried between all our other videos, which sadly it happens. But there it is. I will see you next time with Fire Emblem, guys, and Dragalia Lost. Thank you very much, and I'm so happy to have pulled finally what I wanted. Bye, guys.